The other day, I was sitting at the edge of a small pond in a park, peacefully watching fish and other tiny aquatic animals drifting through the water. I couldn't help but wonder, where did all these little guys come from? Humans may help to populate established lakes and water bodies, but how do you explain the presence of aquatic animals in new water bodies, especially small ones in the middle of nowhere? There are certain places that have large pits or depressions that turn into ponds following heavy rains or flooding in a region. You have likely noticed that fish start to appear in these ponds as if by magic. A similar case occurs with dry ponds. When a pond dries up, and its aquatic inhabitants consequently die, how can more small creatures appear when it fills up again? Fish reach new or replenished ponds in three main ways. They are already there, they get there naturally, or they have some external help getting there. First of all, there are some species of aquatic organisms that lay eggs capable of surviving long droughts and only hatching once conditions are favorable. For instance, algae leave behind spores that can survive for long periods of time. Certain species lay eggs in the mud of a pond, where they lay dormant until the pond is replenished, at which point they come out again, reproduce, and propagate their species in the newly formed water body. Secondly, a piece of land could share a drainage system, whereby different bodies of water share the same water, along with its inhabitants. Many lakes and ponds are formed by larger water bodies, like rivers or the sea. If a river floods, its water might spill over its natural boundaries and accumulate in a low-lying area, creating a small child water body. Fish and other aquatic creatures could enter this small lake through the same streams that act as a liquid highway between the parent river and the newly formed lake. Many lakes and ponds that seem unconnected when the water level is normal are actually connected in different ways, meaning that they contain essentially the same water. While most aquatic creatures travel to newly formed water bodies through one of the above methods, there is another method of migration that fish use, through the help of birds, land animals, and humans. For example, when a bird drinks water from a pond, fish eggs might stick to its feathers or feet. When it flies off to a newly formed pond nearby, the same eggs might uncouple themselves from their host to populate the new pond. The same thing happens with land animals, whose feet and fur could house the eggs of aquatic animals for a journey between two ponds. Humans also play a crucial role in populating ponds by actively or passively introducing selected species of aquatic animals. There are dedicated fish farms and hatcheries where certain fish populations are reared and then released into water bodies that require a population boost. Sometimes, we also release fish into a new water body by carrying them on the bottoms of our boats or other water sporting gear. Regardless of the size of a pond, its newness, or apparent isolation from other water bodies, the appearance of fish and other aquatic organisms can be attributed to one of nature's truest maxims: life finds a way.